And good afternoon. This is News for the Heart. And today I have, one of my favorite co-hosts, Tom Campbell. And he's doing a really interesting project right now, and he's asking for assistance. So we want to promote that a little bit. I say this often, but Tom is just a wealth of knowledge. And if you're ever interested in getting, really understanding some of the work that he's doing and, just getting a better understanding of how entropy and consciousness and our fears play such a huge role in what we do. Now, I know that the research is more on proving that we are basically a virtual reality, which is very cool. And I really like how Tom explains it. And we've done shows on it before, but I do, really enjoy this. And so I want to encourage you that for those of you that love our show, and I know that there's a lot because we get comments all the time, please, join in on this great project and assist Tom. And, we've been doing all this work and you get all this information for free. And Tom has hours and days of workshops on YouTube. So, you can get all of the information you've ever wanted and just, stay there for weeks upon weeks to get that info. So take, do what you can and assist to make this project happen. I think we're already almost at our first goal, so that's awesome. But
yes.
So thanks, Tom, always for joining us. And let's chat a little bit about that, and then we'll get into our own topic.
Okay, well, what we've got going now is a Kickstart, a campaign, a Kickstart campaign, and we're trying to raise money so that we can hire the professional help, the lab space, and the people that will get these experiments done. I have a set of experiments, physics experiments, quantum mechanics experiments that will verify that this is a virtual reality. So the only way these things can work, or the only explanation for them, is that indeed this is a virtual reality. And the reason for doing that is that I would like the physicists to sooner rather than later come to that conclusion that indeed this is a virtual reality, because that means that that we are a subset of something more significant, more fundamental, and that more significant, more fundamental thing is non-physical to us. So that's a pretty big step for science to come along and say that, we're a subset of something non-physical. That's a massive step. And the next step, and it's the only logical conclusion one can come to then, is that consciousness is the computer of this virtual reality. And then once you understand consciousness is a computer and that we are all subsets of consciousness, we the players, as opposed to we the bodies that are the avatars, that consciousness is a social system of individuated units of consciousness, and the way that you optimize a social system is by cooperation and caring and compassion. That's how you optimize a social system. So then the question is, well, what's this virtual reality here for? Why would this system create this virtual reality? And then a little logic takes you to the conclusion that this virtual reality is an entropy reduction trainer. In other words, it's a place for us to make choices to enable us to grow up, to become love, to become more considerate of others, to care about others, to let go of our fear, our ego, our beliefs, and our self-centeredness, and so that it's not all about us, and that this is a place to make choices to learn how to do that. So all of that falls out. So it's not really that these experiments themselves are such a really big deal in the big picture, and the way they are, if they work out the way I say, they'll completely change science. It'll rewrite a whole new version of quantum mechanics. It'll modify relativity. It'll create a whole new science that'll be based on a bigger picture rather than on the little picture of materialism that it's based on now. So the science part of it is pretty neat. That's a big thing by itself. But really the thing that interests me is that it's the first step in a series of a couple of logical steps that takes us to our purpose. What's our purpose? Why are we here? You know, what's the point of us being here? And it's to grow up. It's to decrease our entropy, which is the same thing as saying to grow spiritually, to, you know, become love, to care about others. That's what we're here for. That's on the path of consciousness evolution. And I know just stating it real shortly like that, it'll seem like I'm just making all that up because it sounds good. But really, there is a very tight logic, you know, science that leads to that sequence of conclusions. It's not just me making stuff up because it sounds nice and sweet and happy, you know. It's the way it is. It's the nature of our reality. And when we understand that, then all of the things that are now called paranormal will just be normal. Because when you have an understanding of a bigger picture, all that stuff becomes normal. It's part of the way things are. So now science would be able to tell us about our subjective experiences as well as about our objective experiences. So you see, science now blooms into a whole bigger purview of things that it can say something intelligent about, things that it can turn into facts. So it's kind of a big deal in that sense. If you see where it's all going, you know, my hope is that it will, over a decade or two, actually change the world. And I say that because we've always had people who have understood the big picture. You know, 2,400 years ago, Buddha said that this reality was an illusion. Well, it's the best you could say in those days about this reality being a virtual reality. It's an illusion. It's not real. There's another purpose behind it, and that purpose is to grow up and become love. And the Buddha said all that. So we've had these little bubbles of enlightenment all over the globe. Every nation, you know, every culture has produced those, but they always stay in the margins. They're never mainstream society. They're always in the margins. Well, today, the high priests of our culture, of Western culture anyway, and now Western culture is kind of spread all over the world, so it's pretty much world culture. The high priests of our culture are the scientists. It's the high priests that tell us what to believe. That's always been the role of the high priest. They tell us what is truth and what isn't to the people who really don't want to think for themselves, which is the majority of people. So when the high priests say that this is a virtual reality, and then the logic about consciousness being the computer and love being the answer falls out of that, it will go mainstream. It won't be in the margins anymore. With an internet that can spread things to billions of people in a week, you see, it's not like the times of the Buddha where, you know, to go 20 miles is a long, long trip. And a lot of people never go that far away from where they're born because it takes you, you know, a couple of days to walk that far. So it's not like that. So we have a real good chance now to change the world in the sense that we can get this sense of we're here to grow up, to be kind, to be caring, to be love. And that's our purpose. And that is science, not metaphysics or philosophy. But that comes to us by way of science. So what we've done is we've united physics and metaphysics. We've, you know, the physical and the non-physical, mind and body, all those things now are seen to be, you know, just different views of the same thing. There's just this one big understanding and all those things make sense. So that's what it's about, and these experiments are the thing to try to get that ball rolling, to bring the physicists in, to bring these ideas into the mainstream. So that's what it's all about. And we were trying to raise $150,000 to do these experiments. And experiments are very expensive to do. The equipment's very expensive. Lab space is very expensive. Hiring expertise that's done similar things before is very expensive. So the 150 was really like our very lowest amount. That's just enough to get started. Because with Kickstart, it works like this. You give them a minimum amount or amount that's your goal. If you don't make that goal, you don't get anything. You give it all back. That's the rule for a Kickstart program. So if we only made $145,000 and didn't make $150,000, we don't get a dime. It all goes back. So you try to put in the lowest number there that'll actually allow you to do, you know, some of what you want to do. So that's our 150. It'll probably cost about twice that, about 300,000 to do all of the experiments. So we'd like to just keep on going to see if we can't get enough to do them all. But it looks like we're going to make that 150,000 probably sometime today. We're only about $2,000 short, and we've been gaining at least $2,000 a day at kind of our minimum at the lowest days. And we have almost half the time left. We've got 14 days remaining. That's another rule about Kickstarter. This campaign can only last 30 days. At the end of 30 days, you've either made your goal or not. So those are the limitations. So we've got another 14 days, and if we could double it, if we could go all the way to 300,000, then we would be able to do all of these experiments, a whole set of the experiments. They kind of show different things. So anyway, that's what it's all about, and you can go. Hopefully you will put the Kickstarter page, link, URL, under this, and I'll send that to you if you don't have it. And you can add that to it. And so, ladies and gentlemen who are watching this, if you go click on that, and in 30 days or in 14 days, it's going to be gone. But for the next 14 days, you will be able to contribute to this thing that may be world changing, may be life changing for a lot of people. Yeah. So it's a big, you know, a big historical watershed moment, pretty much. So that's the deal. If you want to be a part of it, then get on over there and see if we can't get enough money to pay for all of the experiments. So that's what it's all about.
Nice.
And fortunately, I think we are going to make our minimum. You know, we look like that's almost a shoo-in at this point. So we won't have to give it all back. That's a good thing. Now all we have to do is get the rest of it. Right. So that you know, we can do everything we want. So anyway, that's where we're going with it. That's what it's all about. And if you have even $10, I think is the minimum contribution. If you even got $10, that's good. That's plenty. Enough people give $10. That's all we need. So join us if you feel like it's something you want to do.
Yeah, it's very exciting. I'm going to put it in my newsletter as well that goes out in a couple days. So hopefully. And the little, I mean, you've created a lovely video. It explains a lot of stuff. I mean, it's fascinating. So good luck with that. I'm glad that you are reaching your first goal already, and we're only halfway there. That's awesome. So yay.
Yeah. We're actually going to get these experiments done, at least some of them.
Right.
We're gonna form a team and get some of them done. So that's very exciting.
That is exciting.
Have a question for Lori and want to be on the next News from the Heart show? Drop us a line via instant feedback at bmajor.org. News from the Heart is brought to you by Intuitive Soul and is produced by Major Radio for Clear Channel's iHeartRadio and bmajor.org.